Welcome to Property Post. Today we have Stephen Dupuis, President and Chief Executive Officer of the Toronto-based Building Industry and Land Development Association. Welcome,
Stephen. Good morning, Garry.
What a difference a year makes, eh? I mean, you think last January, the Canadian housing market, or at least the resale market, was in complete dumps. I mean, would you have ever expected the type of turnaround we have seen?
No way would I have bet on this kind of turnaround, particularly so quickly. I mean, last year at this time, we were all just in fear and wondering and basically bracing for quite a long downturn. So to be sitting here 1 year later and really on an upswing, very surprising.
I mean, you've seen in the resale market, we're seeing tightness of supply like we've never seen in a long time. I've noticed that new home construction has increased to a degree, but not quite enough to fill that supply void. Do you think it's going to increase? Are people still feeling it out in your industry?
Well, in the new home market, it takes a little longer to respond. So builders had kind of hunkered down, and then all of a sudden they saw the market return. So they're bringing some product onto the market. So you're going to see, we always lag a bit, but we're coming along just fine.
Do you think, nationally, 7 years of 200,000starts? Can we get back to those pre-2009 levels?
No, we can't, but whether we need to or not, it doesn't matter. I mean, we will have a good year in 2010. How good it is depends on whether there's any shocks to the system. Nothing anticipated.
Let's talk about the type of houses that are now being built, the stock. It seems to me if you're living in Toronto, you have two choices. You can live downtown in a condo, that's what's being built, or you can head out to the suburbs and get yourself a backyard. Mm-hmm. And it's not just Toronto. I mean, you go to Vancouver and the downtown is just dotted with skyscrapers. Even in St. John's, Newfoundland, they're building condos downtown, albeit, the limit's four stories. So you're not quite in something that you get in Toronto. I mean, is the future of housing a condominium? Is that what it is?
You know, it's evolving. Certainly the Toronto market and the Greater Toronto market has evolved. Toronto's about 80% of the condo business in the Greater Toronto area. You're seeing condos in Richmond Hill and Markham and Mississauga. Across this country, Calgary was an emerging condo market. It's kind of went sideways for a while, but I expect that to come back. Vancouver is a mature condominium market. And, the urban centers, I mean, there's a whole government policy drift towards intensification, and that's nationwide. And it makes sense. It's about the price of energy. It's about the price of land. So the higher those two input factors go, the more you're going to see intensified development, meaning high rise.
So are builders just in love with condos right now because that's what developers want them, or that's where the money is?
Oh, it's where the market is, really. Yeah. With land prices so high, it's really important to try and get that component down. And the only way they can do that is through density.
Let's talk about the market itself. I mean, how much do you think this market has become dependent on interest rates? I mean, you can borrow at prime at 2.25, lock in for 5 years at under 4 or around 4. I mean, I haven't seen anything like this since I've been covering real estate.
It's remarkable, and we know that interest rates are going to stay low for at least the next half a year and perhaps even longer than that. Interest rates are one factor. Affordability is a combination of interest rates and income, and so you've got to put those two factors together. If house prices come down, your affordability goes up. If interest rates are down, no matter what happens to house prices. So there's two or three factors in operation at the same time. Interest rates is what gives people confidence, to go into the market.
Now, we heard a few rumblings out of Ottawa that maybe things are a little hot in the market and they might throw a few brakes on there.
Very surprised that Ottawa would be musing about that. I mean, certainly we're not back to where we were 2, 3, 4 years ago. So, and frankly, we just got rolling. So our view is this is something that really needs to be nurtured, not choked off as it's going. I mean, the housing industry right across this country is all about jobs, whether we're talking condos, new homes, renovation. And, if the federal government wants to stimulate the economy in the name of jobs, then the last sector they should look to slow down is the housing sector.
I mean, if you reduce the amortization period from whatever 35 to the old-fashioned 25 and you make people have more than 5% down, How many people are going to drive out of the market doing that?
Quite a few. I mean, the 5% down is a policy that's been in existence in this country for 15 or 20 years, and it's never been a problem, even when the market was hotter, as long as we qualify people properly and there's due diligence on the part of the lenders. And that's what that system's there for. The amortization, you know, Flaherty already reduced it when it got to the 40 and 35 year level. He kind of clawed that back a bit. That was probably the right thing to do. He could probably go to 30 and not put too many people out of the market. But it's more important that we qualify people properly and do the due diligence on the lending side.
Okay, one last question. We're going to put you on the hot seat. What's your call for 2010? Where do we go from here?
2010, listen, we're ending 2009 on a decidedly up note, and everything I've seen in the market of late suggests that we're going to have a good year in 2011. I wouldn't want to put a number on it, but as I said, barring any shocks to the system, I don't see why things would slow down beyond the point where we're at right now.
Okay, thank you for coming on Property Post.
It's a pleasure, Gary.